Hello, brethren. Pray the Lord. God is good that has given us yet another opportunity, another episode to find Him. And today I come with a message about be strong. Let us pray. Father, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, I thank you for this opportunity that you are giving us to interact with your word so that we may find you more and more. Bless our time together, O God, by the power of your Holy Spirit. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Friends, I thank God for this yet another opportunity. I bring with me the good news from the Word of God. And this good news is not new. It's something that we have been interacting with. And this time around, I bring you a text from Ephesians chapter 6. A very, very common text about the whole armor of God. And this text, Ephesians 6:10, verse 10 up to 18, I just want to run through very quickly because the word of God has to speak by itself. And so Paul says these words, "Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of God that you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we do not wrestle against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this age, against spiritual hosts of wickedness in the heavenly places. Therefore, take up the whole armor of God, that you may be able to withstand in the evil day, and having done all, to stand. Stand, therefore, having guarded your waist with truth, having put on the breastplate of righteousness, and having shod your feet with the preparation of the gospel of peace. Above all, taking the shield of faith with which you will be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked one." And verse 17 says, "And take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. Praying always with all prayer and supplication in the Spirit, being watchful to this end with all perseverance and supplication for all the saints." God is good that He keeps speaking to us all time. And this is a very common text that many people have read, that many people have preached about, that you have read and preached about even. And it is a portion of scripture that we keep interacting with most of the time. But I emphasize verse 10. And verse 10, Paul was winding up his speech to the saints in Ephesus. You know, he had written to them many, many things. And now he concludes his very many things that he had written to them. And these very many things that he had written, he says, "Finally, my brethren, be strong." Because he knew the times were not easy times. And of course, actually, the man, Paul himself, was all the time in prison, all the time facing calamities, all the time actually persecuted. Remember, as earlier, he had been the persecutor of the church, but when he converted, he became the preacher of the word of God through Jesus Christ. The persecution stand against him. And so he knew all the Christian believers would face the same. And the reason why he encourages the Ephesians to put on the whole armor of God. And so in here, we also read, we are saints of this day. We are believers in Jesus Christ of this day. And so he says, "Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might." And then he goes down to enumerate the armor that we need to put on. Now, this portion, Paul was only trying to cheer up his people. And so, the reason why I bring it, my brothers and sisters, is that we needed to cheer one another up. The times are not simple times. the moments that we are in are not cheap, are not easy. And so every time we need to cheer one another. And so I come to cheer you up like Paul was cheering up the Ephesians and telling them, be strong, stand in the power of Christ. And so friends, this is very, very important to be strong, to stand firm during our times. Of course, actually we have experienced very difficult times. Corona has brought it all. And we have faced it, and we have felt it, and we have seen it, we have tasted it, and very many other things. Talk about poverty, talk about various many other diseases, sicknesses. We actually are all on a rampage. And so we need to cheer one another, and this is the portion. And so we need to recognize where our power, where our strength comes from. And you, a believer, and I, a believer, I recognize that my power comes from God. And there is this word which many people have heard about. It's called dunamis. Dunamis is actually those words that are Greek, that are Latin. And you have heard about some radio station or whatever. It is called dunamis radio or something. But it's about inherent power. This dunamis is inherent power. And so our Lord Jesus Christ himself had inherent power that enabled him to perform many miracles. You remember, you read the Bible, and so he had dunamis. And so Jesus himself had inherent power. And so you and me are encouraged to stand in that power that Christ himself gives. The reason why Paul is saying, stand in the power of his might. And so I encourage you to do that. The same Paul tells the Philippians in chapter 4, verse 13, Philippians 4, 13, he says, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Praise the Lord. That God speaks to us, that as Paul spoke to the Philippians, as Paul spoke to the Ephesians, as Paul spoke to the Romans, as Paul spoke to the Thessalonians, and very many of those races, he still speaks to us today, that actually everything that we're able to do, actually this that I'm doing, everything that you're able to do, you do it because it is Christ who supplies us with the strength. Are you able to give a testimony? Are you able to confess your sins? Are you able to pray? Are you able to read the word of God? Are you able to preach to somebody who is out there and finding life uninteresting? Are you able to cheer up some other person? So the Bible is saying, Paul says, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. So Jesus shares his power with us. You know, he commissioned the disciples who later became, after he commissioned them, they became apostles to go and preach. And now that commissioning still stands with you and with me. And so, friends, Paul encouraging the Ephesians, Paul encouraging the people that were listening to him, that he wrote to his letters, he still speaks to us today. We who are ravaged by very many things now, it is now time for politics, of course, yes, and people are finding it in their own way. But remember that we can do all things, you can do all things, I can do all things. And in all things, include all our aspects of life, all aspects of our life. Remember, there is physical life, spiritual life, emotional life, social life, well, every other bit. And when you talk about all things, Paul says all things. Even in your business, yes, that is one of the all things. Even those of you who go to school, even in academics, even those who are joining politics, even in politics, yes, even everything that you know about, that you get engaged in, as long as you confess and profess Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. And so this is something that I needed to share about, and Paul encouraging himself and encouraging others that I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. May we derive our strength from the Lord Jesus Christ. And so, just like Isaiah, in chapter 54, verse 17, Isaiah also knew. I mean, during that time when the Israelites were finding it very difficult, actually Isaiah is divided into three, and I will not go into that. But in this verse, he says, no weapon formed against you will prevail, and you will condemn every tongue that raises against you in judgment. And so why does it mean, what does it mean to say no weapon formed against you will prevail? Because it is God who supplies us with the strength, with the power. And so he surrounds us. Of course, there will be things, there will be thorns that will be coming, there will be arrows that will be coming shot by the evil one. But the Bible is telling us that actually no weapon shall prevail against us. And so when you know what God can and what God will do on our behalf, on your behalf, is what makes us strong. Amen. When you know what God can and what God will do for you, for me, is what makes us strong. And I want to emphasize that one, my brethren, that when you know what God can and what God will do is what makes us strong. And so, remember the words that God told Joshua in chapter 1, verses 5, 6, 7, going down. He just says, be strong. And the same message speaks to us today. Be strong in the midst of all this. And why must we be strong as I end? Why we must be strong is because battle is everywhere. Threats are everywhere. Temptations are everywhere. Anxieties everywhere. Stresses everywhere. Disappointments everywhere. Distresses everywhere. The enemy, the devil, is real. And so when Paul says, finally, brethren, stand firm, is because, why must we be strong? Is because the enemy is roaming. As Peter puts it in 1 Peter chapter 5, verses 8 to 9, of course, we begin from verse 6, he says, your enemy, the devil, roams around. And beginning from verse 6, actually, he says it as I wind up this now, that therefore, humble yourselves under the mighty hand of God, that he may exalt you in due time, casting all your care upon him, for he cares for you. Be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil, walks about like a roaring lion, seeking whom he may devour. Resist him, steadfast in the faith, knowing that he, the same sufferings are experienced by your brotherhood in the world. So be sober, be vigilant. So the devil roams. The Bible talks about him as the accuser of the brethren, as we read in Revelation chapter 12, verses 7 following, and he is a deceiver of the world. So my brothers and sisters, Paul tells the Ephesians in chapter 6, verse 10, be strong, stand in the power of his name. And so you and me, God is calling us, God is encouraging us. We are here to cheer one another up. And I leave this text with you. You can continue reading on, interacting with the word of God, and so that we may grow from one level to another. So God is good that he remains our faithful father. God is good that he remains our faithful protector. God is good that he remains our caregiver in the spiritual realms and in everything. So may this God remain with you and remain with me. And so that you shall remain standing strong. Joshua remained standing strong. And then the walls of Jericho collapsed. I was defeated later on. And everything was defeated. And they entered the promised land. Will you stand strong? Will I stand strong during this time when things are not well? God still remains God. And you and I remain his children. I pray this, believing and trusting that God will keep you and will keep me, so that we remain strong in the name of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.